Hi guys, welcome back. Okay, this is chapter 13, which is equation and inequalities. In this video, I am going to talk about 13.1, which is solving linear equations, and 13.2, solving some problem using linear equations. Okay, let's get started. Okay, in chapter 9, we have learned some expanding, simplifying and factorizing expression. So today we are talking about equation. Actually, what is the difference between expression and equation? To do that, let's see. Expression is actually a combination of terms with unknown, just like this case. So for x plus 2, you can see you have one unknown here, you have another term here. This is considered a first term, second term. So you have different types. You may have this type, you may have this type. As long as we have unknown, we call this as expression. On the other hand, equation is the expression with an equal sign in between. That's like this. If you have 4x plus 2 equal to 1, then you have one equal sign here, then this one considered as one equation. And this is another equation, this is another equation, this is another equation. Okay, in this lesson, we are going to solve some linear equation, meaning to say, if you have an equation like this, we are trying to solve what is the x value. Okay, so sometimes the equation is involving x and y and a and b and z. Any letter will do. Let's see one example. If we have 3x minus 2 equal to 4, then the answer is, this is how we do. 3x will bring minus 2 to this side, become plus 2, so that we have an answer as 6. So if 3x equal to 6, x will be equivalent to 2. Okay, so let's see B. B, if we have negative 4y plus 2 equal to 12, so we want to get rid of this positive 2, I'll bring to this side, become minus 2. So in the end, 12 minus 2, you get 10. Negative 4y equal to 10, so we want to get y, so you divide it with negative 4. So in the end, your answer is -5/2. This negative, you can put in the middle here. You can give it to 5 or give it to 2. This one, either one of them, right? Okay, let's see C. If we have negative B as unknown, you can actually bring this to that side, become positive B like this. It's not necessary the unknown must be at left hand side, it can be at right hand side. So in this case, I'll bring this negative B to positive to this side, become positive B. But this 4 originally is positive, so I bring here become minus. So say 16 minus 4, that's why you get 12 as equal to B. Okay, D, if we have two unknown like this, you have one here and we have one here, we need to collect at one side, just like this case. I'll bring this positive A to this side, become minus A. And on the other hand, this negative 4, I'll bring it here, become positive 4. So you can see 3A and minus, 3A minus A, you get 2A. Because they are like term, you can simplify it. Then you get 4, then A will equivalent to 2, right? Okay. Let's see another question. In this question, you can expand this, make it 4y plus 4 equal to 8. Okay, then you want to get rid of this positive 4, bring here, become minus 4. That's why you get 4 here, 8 minus 4, you get 4, which is which lead you the y answer as 1 in this case. So on the other hand, we also can use another method to do. That's just like this. We can actually divide first, use 8 divided by 4 first to get 2. So you want to get y, so you bring this positive 1 to this one, minus 1. So 2 minus 1, you get 1 back. So you can see two ways will give the same answers. It's up to you to use which one. Okay, F. So if we have unknown here, we have unknown here, we need to collect the unknown at one side and the number will be at the other side, just like this. So I'll retain negative 3x here. I bring this negative 2x becomes here, become positive 2x. So this 8 I didn't touch, so still remain a positive 8. Then this 5 original here is positive, bring it to this side, become minus. So in the end, I have 3 for this side and this one become minus x. But what we want is actually positive x, not minus x. So what you do is just multiply negative 1 to it so that you got positive. This one become minus 3. Okay. Next question. If we have question like this, you can expand it just like this, multiply. So negative x become this part will become minus x. And this this part, however, become positive. Please don't make this mistake. Negative times negative becomes positive. All right. All right. Then after that, we collect the number at one side as usual. And this negative x, I will bring it to here, become positive x. So in the end, our answer of x is equivalent to 11. Okay. So what is the purpose of finding all this x, x, y, y thing? It's actually when we sub this back to this, so we'll get this 4, just like 12 minus 11 minus 3, then you get the answer as 4. This is how we need to, this is what we call as, we need to find this unknown to make this equation a correct one, right? Okay. Next one, we try to solve some problems using linear equation, just like this case. If you have a number, if you double it, and then you add to it, if the total is equivalent to 28, what is that number actually? That is a question. So this, if you have this kind of sentence, we try to make an equation like this. Because 2x, x is the unknown, you double it means you times 2, then you plus 8, then the question said equivalent to 28. So you make this equation yourself, construct this first. Then after that, solve the x by using the normal way just like just now. 28 minus 8, that means you have 20. Then in the end, you have x equal to 10, right? So let's see another question. Subtract 1 from the number and multiply the result by 5. If the answer is 35, what is the number? So from here, make a equation also. X is the unknown, you minus 1 because subtract 1 from it, and then you times 5 equivalent to 35, the question said. So from here, you can divide first, like 35 divided by 5, you get 7. So we want to find X will be equivalent to 8. All right. So this is how we form this and then solve it using algebra, where instead of you guess the answer. Okay. C, it can be a picture form. The question said the perimeter of this shape is 2 to 4. The question is asking what is the value for x, okay? Don't forget, because this one never give you, so we need to find out. This is supposed to be 12 plus 3x, so you need to get it yourself. And this one also, we need to know what is the value here. Because the total is 7x, and this is 3x, so this one's supposed to be 4x, because 7x minus 3, you get 4 here, all right? Then from here, how to get perimeter? Perimeter will be every side you plus together, just like this. 7x plus 12 plus 6 plus 6 plus all of this equivalent to 2 to 4. Then from here, you try to simplify. In the end, you get x equivalent to 10. All right? This is how we solve this kind of question. Another one is this one. You have a rectangle, which one side is equal to x. cm given, and the question said the width is 2 cm shorter than the length, and if the perimeter is 24, find the value of x. Okay, so firstly we need to know what is the width here. How much is that? Since it says it's 2 cm shorter, that means x minus 2 is your expression here. Then after that, we need to find out what is perimeter means. Perimeter means we add all four sides here. So you have 2 of the x here and 2 of the width here. So equivalent to 24, the question said. Then after that, you try to expand this, and then simplify it. In the end, you get the answer x equivalent to 7. That means when the x is equal to 7, then you get a 24 for the perimeter. Okay. For question 2, if let's say the question asks you the area, since we know the x is equivalent to 7, so this is 7 now, and this one has to be 5, right? So in the end, our answer is 7 times 5, which is 35 cm squared. All right. Okay. Another question. Let's say Madeline is M years old now. I don't know what is her age. Okay. She said, in 8 years' time, I shall be twice as old as I was 3 years ago. That means if she was in 3 years, I don't know what is age. Then in 8 years' time from now, her age will be double the one when she was 3 years younger. So in this case, we can actually make an equation like this. Write an expression. Madeline age in 8 years time. That means if the current age is M, in 8 years time, the age supposed to be M plus 8, right? The M plus 8 will be your answer, okay? Number two, Madeline age in 5 years old, 5 years ago, it will be, no, it's 3 years ago, supposedly. This is wrong. This is a mistake here. 3 years ago, because 3 years ago. So it will be M minus 3. This is the age she was in 3 years ago. All right. So the questions now you need to based on this this statement to make an equation from this. So the question will ask you to write down an equation M to find out her current age, which is the M, right? So in this case, you do this. M plus 8 will be equivalent to 2 times when she was 3 years ago. So this is how you make the statement. This is the age after 8 years. This is the age 3 years ago. So it says it should be twice as old. So that means you need times 2 here. From here, you solve this. Then you get the M equivalent to 14. So this is how we get the answer. Okay. So that means the current age of hers, it will be 14. Okay. So let's see another example. Joshua, Kendra, Kelly, Yuki, Mikael, and they are recording. Sometime they do their homework. If Joshua texts If Joshua texts T minutes to finish the exercise, the table asks you to write down the expression of some statement here, some description here. Say, Kendra texts 20 minutes longer than Joshua. How do we write the expression right here? Okay. Since Joshua is taking T minutes, so if 20 minutes longer, that means T plus 20 will be Kendra time to finish the homework. Then the next one, Kelly texts twice as long as Kendra. If Kendra is this much already, the minutes, then Kelly will be double. So that means you times 2 to it, or you can expand it, become 2T plus 4T. Okay. Then Yuki texts 10 minutes less than Kelly. So that means from here, you need to minus up 10 minutes. So that's why you have 2T plus 30 only. Instead of 40, you need to minus 10. That's why this is your answer. And then for this case, if T divided by 2, how do we describe this? How do Mikael text how long if T over 2? T over 2 means half of Joshua time. You need to write this as your answer, okay? So this is how we answer this kind of question, right? All right? So basically, this is the end of this 13.1 and 13.2. So you can do your some practice in these two exercises, and then if you have any problem, you can contact me as soon as possible. Right, thank you.